one of the other most important servers for analysis, for functional analysis and characterization and annotation, is the EGNOG database and EGNOG server, which allows for orthology predictions and functional annotation of a protein sequence or a set of protein sequence. So we can search EGNOG using a single sequence, or we can search EGNOG using more than one protein sequences as well. The initial step in the EGNOG pipeline is the clustering of almost 9.6 million proteins, which have been characterized from 2031 sequenced genomes. Homology comparisons are executed initially, and then it is processed by the EGNOG orthology prediction pipeline. Orthologous groups are automatically generated by dividing species into core species, which are central for defining orthologous groups using the strict triangular criterion, and periphery species, which are accessory to the orthologous category. Functional annotation is performed using two parallel approaches, which summarizes known attributes of the group members and then determines which annotations can be robustly propagated to the group as a whole. Functional descriptions are provided based on a heuristic procedure, seeking the most informative description that characterizes the annotated members of the group. And functional categories introduced in cluster of orthologous groups, KEG orthology, are employed. This is a controlled vocabulary of 20 functional categories to which the orthologous groups of those databases are assigned, and similarly, non-supervised orthologous groups are assigned to these categories using support vector machine classification, as was described in your Cello analysis pipeline. The same principle of support vector machine as a machine learning algorithm is used, and several available other annotation sources such as SMART, PFAM, Gene Ontology are also used for generating the final prediction. So let us check out how we can submit our sequence. So we will go to the option of sequence search in EGNOG, and we will submit our sequence of interest, which is our test sequence, as we have been using for our analysis. So let us use the test sequence, and we will then click on search. The result page that will be generated is this. As you can see, the first result that you get is the best set of orthologous group in context to the sequence that has been submitted. Remember, we said that we are working with a eukaryotic protein. So you can see the group that has been found to be most similar in context of orthology is Ophisthoconta. Then if you go down further, you will find there are instances from eukaryota as a whole, Viridiplanti, which is the plant segment, Proteobacteria, unclassified bacteria, Acufici, Acidobacteria, so on and so forth. So there are other members, orthologous members that have been found, and it is important to note that all the descriptions incorporate that same description which we identified in our all the analysis that we have performed before, apart from the Cello prediction and the Signal P prediction. And these are all the similar orthologous functions, cold shock protein, DNA binding, these have also been identified in previous analysis as well. So what we need to do from this particular segment, since we are focusing on the most prolific orthologous group, which is Ophisthoconta, what we will do is we will try to download the sequences corresponding to Ophisthoconta. So there are 78 sequences, and all of these sequences are available in FASTA format. If we click on this, then this particular page will open, which contains all the 78 sequences belonging to this orthologous group. What we will do is we will copy these sequences and we will paste these sequences in a notepad file. As you can see, this notepad file which has been created. Apart from all the 78 sequences of that orthologous group, we have incorporated our test sequence in this particular segment as well, okay. And this is done so that this particular text file that is now generated is a multiple FASTA file, and we can now use this particular file to perform, or the sequences that are contained within this particular file, to generate a multiple sequence alignment and a corresponding phylogenetic tree. So how we will generate the phylogenetic tree? We will copy all these sequences. We will copy all the sequences that are here in this file. Copy, and we will go to an online tool which is known as Clustal Omega. This is a tool for generating multiple sequence alignment and phylogenetic tree. We will paste our sequences here. As you can see, all the sequences that were contained in the text file is now provided here. Our test sequence also finds its place in this particular segment. We will keep all the default parameters unchanged and we will click on submit. Once we click on submit, this kind of a segment will appear, and finally we will be directed to this kind of a result page. As you can see, there are several options. This is your multiple sequence alignment that has been generated. As you can see, there are several gaps and there are several areas which are conserved across the sequences under study, and probably the conserved areas are corresponding to the conserved domains that we have identified in our earlier analysis. And then if we go upwards again and click on phylogenetic tree, we will find a tree data that is being generated in the form of a NUIC format, and this is our phylogenetic tree which incorporates all the most common orthologous sequences pertaining to our test sequence. See, our test sequence is also finding a place in one of the, as part of one of the sister nodes that are provided here, okay. So then what we need to do, we need to then copy and paste this particular image of the tree and save it for our future use. Following that, we will again go back to our EGNOG result page, which is this page, and we will click on the phylogenetic tree that the EGNOG page was providing us with. Now remember, this phylogenetic tree does not have our test sequence in it, so we did not copy any kind of any information from this phylogenetic tree segment. But let us see what kind of phylogenetic tree this EGNOG database is providing us with, then we can understand here, okay. So as you can understand that this is the phylogenetic tree that we were being provided with, and if we go back to our result page of Clustal W and try to locate the node with which we had the test sequence. So see, this is the test sequence. It is found to be present in a sister node with either this particular sequence nomenclature or this particular sequence nomenclature. And if we can check this particular sequence nomenclature here, let us check if we can find that. Okay, probably it's a Java active server page, hence this particular search will not work. You can then actually just look at it manually as well if we can find this particular nomenclature. It is XP0105, so let us go down further. Let us see if we can find the specific sequence pertaining to this. Here, see, we have been able to locate the nomenclature sequence here. So this is the organism which is found to be the most nearest ortholog. So let us search in Google what this organism is. Okay, so this is bald eagle. Okay, so this gives you an information regarding what kind of organism this is. Let us close this up and again go back to the page of Clustal W. This is another nomenclature or sequence nomenclature that we are looking to find, ENSXEETP number of zeros 354. So let us see if we can find that in the eggnog table somewhere. Let us now check what that particular sequence belongs to. ENSXET, let us search that. Yeah, so this is Xenopus. As you can see, this is Xenopus. So Xenopus, obviously we all know that it is a western clawed frog. So as you can understand, these are the two most nearest orthologs to our test sequence, and this is how you have to comment on all the individual sequences and their corresponding organisms that are housed in this particular phylogenetic tree, which will give us an idea regarding the phylogenetic position of our test sequence as well. So this is in whole how we analyze results from eggnog and how we use the results that we get from eggnog to generate a proper phylogenetic tree and study the position of our test sequence in comparison with the orthologous sequences from other organisms.